Belinda presents this unabridged recording of Hinduism, A Beginner's Guide, written by Klaus K. Klostermaier and read by Deidre Rubenstein. Preface. This Beginner's Guide to Hinduism is the first volume in a trilogy, which includes Hinduism, A Short History, and Hindu Writings, A Short Introduction to the Major Sources. The latter offers extracts from classical and modern sources, paralleling and supporting the short introduction. It also contains a full bibliography of all literature referred to. The short history provides a chronological overview of the development of Hinduism from its beginnings till now. A concise encyclopedia of Hinduism summarizes in a lexical form the information contained in the three volumes. Hinduism, A Beginner's Guide, does not presuppose any knowledge of the subject, nor does it aim to exhaust it. It is written for the interested general reader and hopes to generate further interest in this rich and vast culture. Short specialized reading lists are given at the end of each chapter. I hope that listeners will find this beginner's guide to Hinduism not only informative, but also enjoyable. There remains the pleasant duty of acknowledging help and support in preparing this book. I thank in particular my wife, Dr. Doris Klostermaier, who carefully read the whole manuscript and made me aware of the need to give due attention to women's concerns in Hinduism. I thank Sonia Droji for checking the manuscript for spelling and grammar. I owe much to Dr. Julius Lipner, Cambridge, who made numerous detailed suggestions for improvement. Last but not least, I wish to thank Novin and Juliet Dustar and their staff from One World for their interest and care in the production of this volume. Klaus K. Klostermaier, Oxford. Introduction. Hinduism is a pilgrimage to Tirupati, a political program, a profound philosophy, a way of life, a sermon on the Bhagavad Gita, a life of asceticism, a joyful evening of hymn singing at a home in Bombay, a ritual routine for Brahmins, a temple festival at Madurai, a dip in the Ganges, and many, many other things to the over 800 million people who are called Hindus. Hinduism has no known founder, and its beginnings point to prehistoric roots. It is unquestionably the oldest living major religious tradition. Until recently, one could not become a Hindu. One had to be born a Hindu. Only someone belonging to a recognized jati, caste, with a Hindu mother and father, who had undergone the prescribed rituals and had not committed a breach of the traditional way of life, could be a member of the Hindu community. Originally, Hinduism was confined to India. Crossing the Dark Sea, emigrating to the West, was associated with loss of caste and exclusion from the Hindu community. Nowadays, there are an estimated 45 million Hindus living outside India, of whom about 18 million live in Nepal, the only country in the world which has declared Hinduism its state religion, and about 15 million in Bangladesh, the former East Bengal. About 2 million Hindus live in Western Europe and North America. And modern Hindu missionary movements also attract Westerners to their fold, granting them equal status with born Hindus. Hinduism appears in a bewildering variety of shapes and forms, and is presented and interpreted by its adherents in such a multitude of ways that it is extremely difficult to describe and impossible to define, as far as its content is concerned. While in the West it is treated as one of the major religions in the world, for Hindus it is much more than that. It is a way of life, a large and rich culture, an environment that envelops a Hindu from before birth to after death. What we call Hinduism, Hindus themselves designate as Sanatana Dharma, eternal law. It is identical with universally valid and generally binding insights and precepts, specified so as to accord with individuals' standing within society. Within the framework of the Sanatana Dharma, a great many different sampradayas, religious communities with specific beliefs, rituals, and places of worship, flourish. Traditions that have histories of thousands of years, like Hinduism or Christianity, have branched out into many different phenotypes that are often in opposition to each other. Adherents of one of the existing branches often claim to be the only true representatives of tradition, accusing others of having betrayed or misinterpreted the original message. From such a sectarian standpoint, it would be meaningless to attempt a global description of the tradition as a whole, and one would have to content oneself with a parallel treatment of major religious communities. However, what appears to the insider as a central difference is often seen by the outsider as but a variation on a theme that can be perceived and traced back to the origins. In a representation of Hinduism as a whole, as is attempted here, we will not overlook the major differences that brought the major and minor sampradayas into existence and make them the communities they are. We will, however, aim not to lose the larger perspectives and emphasize common origins as well as common themes that tie the hundreds of different manifestations of Hinduism together. That makes it meaningful to speak of Hinduism, instead of juxtaposing detailed descriptions of hundreds of unrelated communities that each have their own peculiar beliefs and practices. In this beginner's guide, we shall deal with four approaches designed to throw light on various dimensions of Hinduism. 1. The cultural sociological framework provided by the Vedic tradition to which all Hindus subscribe, at least nominally. 2. The great diversity of religions such as Vaishnavism, Shaivism, Shaktism, and their subdivisions, which separates Hindus into many different and sometimes competitive communities. 3. The intense intellectual quest that led to the development of numerous philosophical schools concerned with universal issues. 4. The developments within Hinduism triggered off by its encounter with the modern West since the late 18th century. As one would expect, there is a widespread of individual commitment and active practice of religion among Hindus. There are those who devote their entire lives to practicing and propagating a particular devotion or philosophy. And there are others for whom Hinduism is an embarrassment, a remnant from an unenlightened age, a formality that one submits to for the sake of family. As a community, however, Hindus are arguably the most intensely religious people on earth. Nowhere but in India can one find such enormous masses participating in religious festivities. And nowhere else can one find so many temples, shrines, and images that attract constant worshippers. Hinduism as a culture has also become highly relevant in Indian politics in recent decades. Political parties utilize traditional symbols and popular practices to attract people's attention and to promote Hindu agenda. This beginner's guide cannot aspire to an exhaustive description of even a small part of Hindu reality. What it attempts to do is to highlight important expressions of the Hindu tradition in such a way that Hindus can recognize it as their own, and non-Hindus can understand some of the aspects of living Hinduism. The emphasis will be on the ideal that Hinduism aims at, not on the empirical and historical facts. Religions mean to provide their followers with notions of human perfection and ideals of life. Shortcomings of adherents of a particular religion, however evident and gross, must not be blamed on the tradition or identified with it. For thousands of years, India has been a veritable laboratory of religion. Everything imaginable seems to have been tried out, and nothing ever completely rejected. Homegrown religions and religions from outside have existed side by side, mostly peacefully, sometimes in competition with each other, occasionally violently clashing. In spite of many attacks on Hinduism, from inside and outside, in spite of rumors of decay and disarray, Hinduism has outlived all announcements of its impending demise. It may appear amorphous and archaic, but it has put its stamp on all religions that attempted to displace it. Hinduism has been compared to a huge banyan tree, which keeps growing and developing ever new roots that transform into trunks, from which grow new shoots and branches, again and again. Hinduism is infinitely fascinating, surprising, and challenging. Something of this fascination and challenge, which the author experienced in his many years of life in India and in his many more years of studying and teaching Hinduism, will hopefully become apparent in this beginner's guide to Hinduism. Suggested further reading. Brockington, J.L. The Sacred Thread, Hinduism in its Continuity and Diversity, Edinburgh University Press, Edinburgh, 1981. Fuller, C.J. The Camphor Flame, Popular Hinduism and Society in India, Princeton University Press, Princeton, 1992. Klostermaier, Klaus K. A Survey of Hinduism, State University of New York Press, Albany, NJ, 2nd edition, 1994. Lipner, Julius. Hindus, Their Religious Beliefs and Practices, Routledge, London and New York, 1994. Mittal, S&Q, Thursby Editors, The Hindu World, Routledge, New York and London, 2004. Radhakrishnan Sarvapalli, Indian Philosophy, 2 volumes, George Allen and Unwin, London. First published in 1927. Many reprints. Part 1. The Vedic Tradition. Before the words Hindu and Hinduism became accepted, they are terms introduced by foreigners, Persians, Greeks, and the English, the Hindus called their tradition Vaidika Dharma, the Vedic Dharma. Dharma is one of those words that are virtually untranslatable because of the large number of meanings they have in their original context. It only partly overlaps with the Western notion of religion. It designates, first and foremost, the universal law that is believed to govern everything, and that existed even before the creation. In a more specific sense, Vedic Dharma is the application of this universal, timeless law to Indian society, and the regulation of all aspects of life according to its principles. Its most basic and socially relevant expression is the stratification of Indian society into 4 hierarchically ordered varnas, literally, colors. Vedic Dharma is built on the assumption that all humans have rights and duties according to the varna they are born into. Vedic Dharma is based on a large mass of canonical literature, collectively called Veda, knowledge. It was transmitted orally for many centuries and kept secret from outsiders, and was commented upon and interpreted by respected scholars and sages whose work also acquired a status of authority. Veda-based notions of caste, Vedic rituals accompanying birth, marriage, and death, Vedic notions of purity and pollution, and Vedic divisions of life stages provide a framework.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.